So, doctor, why is it bigger on the inside? Already told you the answer. 100 million thousand whatever times. And the answer is some weird, crazy, timey-wimey stuff. Okay? What does that mean? No idea. Look, okay, just go with the fact that it's bigger on the inside. I mean, you basically almost broke the door hinges off going in, out, in and out again, in and out, etc., etc. And then you went outside, basically ran a marathon around the whole thing, just yelling it's big on the inside. You attracted an old woman towards you. She almost hit you with a brick. So I suggest that you don't do that again. Okay. Cool, now we're on to a agreement. Let's just get out of there. Alright. So you said that we can go anywhere in space and time? I'm sorry, did I like activate something on the sonic screwdriver that allows Mr. Jesse Fox to repeat every bloody thing I say? Yes, I said that. So, where are we going? Well, let's just say it's out of this world. Ha ha! Just like randomly flew somewhere without even going. Hey, so what I always do is just a thing that I do, and you should not ask questions about what I do because it's what I do. I wonder where we are. It looks like some kind of maze thing. Are you always this like really observant? No, because there's stairs here, so. Mazes have stairs? How many mazes have you seen with stairs? Well, I mean, like, some of them do, and like, okay. I will take that as zero. Alright, let's just. That didn't work. Ew! Woo! Doctor, did you just lick the spaceship? Yes, I did. Oh. Aluminum. Wow. Lots of aluminum. And this is aluminum, alright. It's aluminum. So we're on an airplane? I want you to look at me. Does this look like a bloody airplane? Could airplanes travel in space? Not really. Oh, right. So, I say that because this is aluminum, it is man-made. Don't you think so? Sure. All right. So, whoever made this is apparently gone. Yes, so this must be abandoned. How do you know that? Hold on one second. I no in there. You see? That's all you gotta do. Okay. That's all you got to do. Okay. You wanna stay here? Or... Wait, just because you yelled, hey, I mean, that doesn't really mean that this place is abandoned at all. It just... Maybe these are soundproof walls. I mean, couldn't they be? Ooh, I like the way you're thinking. Well, if it were not abandoned, then it would probably be filled with people. And because it's not filled with people, a ship that's possibly extremely big, I say it's abandoned. But weird. How can a ship just go abandoned without some weird thing behind it? I mean, they must have left something behind. A robot. I mean, something. It's just illogical to leave behind a, a robot. Oh, sorry. I think I just broke the spaceship. No, you just ripped off a part. Don't worry about it. What? Yeah, this is just not aluminum. It's just something. I have no idea what this is. So, I wonder who that robot was. We'd like to go see. Yeah. Let's go. Where in the world is this robot thing? Jesse, you think that the door to this robot thing is like right on our noses. You ever get that feeling where the door to someplace amazing is just right under your nose? I mean, it could be just to my left right here, and it is to my left right there. I'm not gonna say anything weird now. You just keep talking sense to me and I'll just listen to you. Right. That was incredibly scary. Let's go. Weird. Jesse. Yeah? I don't like this. Doctor, what is that? It's a core. And that is our robotic voice. Alright. I'm going to act very, extremely nice to it, alright? You just don't do anything and you just sit here. Don't do anything stupid, basically. Okay. Good. Hello, you old scrumptious peanut butter field robot. How are you doing today? This is my colleague, Jesse Fox, if you want his last name, but you want his, I don't know, Twitter, whatever. Why would he want my Twitter? You don't know if it's a he, it could be a she. It sounded like a he. Why, yes it did. Good observation there, Jesse. Right, so, I'm the doctor, and exactly who are you? Because I have no idea who you are, so could you tell us your name, please? Oh, voice chameleon. I like the sound of that. You have a chameleon circuit inside of you. Now, voice chameleon. It's possible that one of us might have had our voice copied. So, whose voice did you copy then? Doctor. right, then it's mine. Wonderful. So somehow you have copied my voice, and now you're using it against its owner. Not bad for a robot. Doctor. What? I want to welcome you. Alright. Thank you for the welcoming party of one, I guess. Where are we? You're in the ship that has traveled across galaxies, Doctor. Now, Doctor, welcome to the Phoenix. Doctor, are you okay? Jesse, this is a legendary Phoenix. The spaceship that has traveled galaxies. What do you mean? The ship left in the year 2300 in search of new worlds. Never returned because it never could find its way back home. Oh, the wives were sad, but they did continue life on this huge, amazing work of art. I just want to tell you that we are in the year 8400. What? So yes, technically you're about 63,000 years old, maybe 63,000, 6350, I don't know, something like that. But that's not it. They continue life on this vessel. But no life is here except for us. Excuse me, Mr. What was your name? My name. Doctor. I am the Prophecy. The Prophecy? I like that name. You like that name? I love that name. Lovely name. Good name. So, wait, why are you called the Prophecy? Don't really know. It was a nickname given to me when the ship was built. Oh, okay. Okay, so you're kind of like the HAL 9000 of the Phoenix, except not evil. That's nice. Yes, not evil. Yes, okay. So, what exactly happened here? Sickness, Doctor. Sickness that took our entire fleet. You had a fleet? We have two ships with us. A medical center, spare one just in case ours broke down. And then we had lab science. They collected different types of asteroids as we traveled along the galaxies. Women, children, men, even pets. So sickness took everybody on the ship. Yes, Doctor. Everyone. The ship's population when it left in 2300 was over 1,000. How many people lived when they died? Over 30,000, Doctor. 30,000 good lives lost that day, Doctor. Good men, happy children, lovely woman, adorable pets. everyone. Everyone but you, I suppose, but I don't understand. Where did this sickness come from? Come from? Observe the table, Doctor. Over here? Yes, Doctor. What? In the year 6300. Doctor, what's in there? What is that? I don't know. The plague was called Insinformia. Insinformia? What is that? No one knew. Until we got it ourselves. What happened? What happened to this place? Just tell me. Please. The crew started falling apart, turning against each other. I watched as savage men ripped out the throats of others, even their own wives. I watched them throw their children against the wall, Doctor. It was horrible. Couldn't take it no more. I contacted the captain. He didn't listen. He became like the rest of them, savage and heartless, Doctor. Pity for him. He was the last one to die. I sent him in vain. You sent him? Technically, no. He tried to shut me down. Leave no existence of this ship. Make it a lost piece of metal in the sea of stars. I couldn't let that happen. So, Doctor. Yes? What do you want? If you and your colleague want to take refuge here and then go far, I will allow you. Thank you. Prophecy. Don't mention it. Never. Mention it. Doctor? What is it, Jesse? Why are you so sad all of a sudden? Nothing. It's just... ...30,000 people died that day. Everyone died. Doctor, you couldn't do anything about it. It's not your fault that those people died. And I know whose fault it is. You heard the hesitation in that robot's voice, didn't you? He was pretty hesitant. It's like he knew something. Yeah. You wouldn't think he... I knew he kind of did remind me of that HAL 9000. Because he is a HAL 9000, like the rare Phoenix. So, what are you gonna do? I want you to look at these readings. Okay? But, I know. When he was talking, I scanned the floor of the call room. It was not aluminum. It's an alloy. The core room was made of an alloy. The alloy was made from iron and steel. Why would the whole ship be made out of aluminum, but that room isn't? That is the question that I am trying to answer. Why did the people die? That's it. You ever see those movies, Jesse? When the robots turn on the human makers. Yeah, but you don't really think, no. I don't really think. I am definitely 100% sure that the reason they died was jealousy. A robot looking among 300. Sorry, tongue twister. 30,000 people, maybe more, of men, women, and children, and pets, and other things, just living off their lives in happiness. And there he is, just there. No one to spend his life. No one to hold close to him. No one to love. So I know why they died. The airlock. He has the ability, as you saw on the hologram screen, to turn on any part of the ship. He has the power to open the airlock. But he knows whenever something is coming, he can direct the ship away from anything if he can open the airlock. And he saw something worthwhile. Maybe he didn't direct it away. So, the robot used something from outer space. Used something that the humans never saw or never even heard of. He used it to kill 30,000 people that day. Wait a minute. I know what we have to do. The Phoenix, an entire man-made ship. Aluminum here, aluminum there, there, and up there. The calls room. Iron and steel. Why? I know why. I know exactly why. Hello, prophecy. Doctor. I have a few things to ask you. One. So, the disease in the whatever. How did it get in? The airlock was left open. Oh, the airlock was left open. How unfortunate of someone to leave the airlock open. Or should I say something, eh? Doctor, what are you talking about? Oh, I think you know exactly what I'm talking about. You have control over the entire ship. Left, right, north, south, everywhere on the Phoenix. You can control it. See, what you couldn't control is whatever is out there in that sea of stars you were talking about. So you decided to use that to your advantage, didn't you? Because you have control over the entire ship, you used your special power to open up the airlock and let in that horrible disease which killed everyone. And then the captain tried to stop you. So you stopped him in return. The whole plan backfired and everyone died. Except for you. The prophecy. The evil core of the Phoenix. Doctor. Of course, it's really weird how the whole entire ship is man-made. But for some mysterious reason, this room, iron and steel, is holding you. And I know why. You're made of mercury. How could you know? Oh, it's pretty obvious. How you're shut off from every aluminum supply in the entire ship. How you never moved an inch except for there and the entire system. Not touching a single block of aluminum. You will not survive this. Oh, I think I will, considering that glass, whatever that is around you, is protecting us from you shooting any high-tech sci-fi lasers at us. But you know, the builders of this ship forgot one simple thing, prophecy. Something that you cannot even detect yourself. They forgot what was above you. Of course, you were already there. They never got to that. So, this whole room, made out of iron and steel, but right above you, is pure shining aluminum. And now I want to ask you one question. Say it, Doctor. What would happen if I did this? Doctor, what are you up to? If I can overload the circuits inside your body, the circuits filled or designed from or protected maybe from mercury, if I can overload that, then it will explode along with you, along with what's above you, and along with this ship. You wouldn't do that, Doctor. With you gone, there is no point in the ship anymore. Everyone was lost. It's over. Prophecy. Doctor, may you stop. Save the pep talks for someone who needs it. I knew what I had to do, Jesse. And I did the right thing. Prophecy had to be stopped. He was blinded by his own wanting for a life outside of the circuit. So, what happened to the Phoenix? The Phoenix was made of aluminum. Prophecy had protective mercury around his circuit board. When mercury is let loose onto aluminum, it burns through. So what actually happened to it? It's probably falling through space right now. Gravity is taking its toll, or black hole will probably suck it in, I don't know. Something will happen to it that it will not be no more after the year 8400. Well, I still can't believe that 3,000 or 300,000 even people died that day. So, wait. So, what's the total death count? 3,000. Oh, wow. And one. So where to now, Doctor? I don't know. Probably some amazingly cool place. Where do you think we're going? No idea.